Hola, ¿cómo estás? Me llamo Stacy Apodaca. Bienvenidos a mi canal. Just kidding, this is not a Spanish video yet, but I am thinking about doing a Spanish video soon. I literally just started filming, you guys. Oh, these construction workers, I started giving me a headache. All right, I think the construction workers kind of came down a little bit. What's up, you guys? What's really, really good? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Stacy Apodaca. ¿Cómo están?
Hi, how are you?
Today, I decided that I wanted to vlog. I'm so excited. I don't know what I'm gonna title this video, but if you guys can tell, we're gonna be traveling. So like I was telling you earlier, I feel like ever since I told you guys that I wasn't gonna be doing YouTube anymore, I just been feeling so inspired to film and to show you guys like everything, and I don't know, just like sharing more of my life. Because like I told you guys in that video, if you haven't seen it, go check it out. I literally said like before I felt like I had to create content that I thought you guys were gonna like, and now I feel like I'm like, oh, this is interesting, I want to film it, and then you guys happen to like it. So that's lit, that's cool, it's cool. I'm still getting used to my extensions. I'm finding some angles that they don't look very good in. For example, when I go like this, I'm still kind of like learning how to work with them so they don't look too fake. But at the end of the day, their extensions are fake. It's fine. What are we gonna do about it, right? Part of this video is that I'm gonna be going on a trip. Well, not only me, actually, me, my sister, Amy D, Danny J, my boyfriend, and Samantha, aka Mexican Chun-Li. Four of us are gonna be taking a trip, so I'm so excited. And you will never guess where we're going. We're going to mi patria, Los Mochis, Sinaloa. I'm so excited because every time I go to Mochis, we get to see my family, we get to spend time with them. I get to see my grandma, you guys. Finally, I get to see my grandma. And I get to finally just be around people that I love. And some people, but most people, like 99.9% of them, I'm super excited to see. Not only that, but I also get to show my boyfriend and one of my closest friends, Samantha, where I'm from, what it's like where I'm from. And I get to show you guys and bring you guys along for the ride. Last year, I did a video when I went to Mochis, and it's called Welcome to My Hometown, Los Mochis, Sinaloa. It's actually one of my most viewed videos, and there I took you guys through like a bunch of different places to go eat and stuff, and we went for my cousin's wedding. So it was last year. This year we're gonna be going for my other cousin's quince, so I'm so excited for Dana's quinceañera. I'm a madrina, bitch. Me and Amy are madrinas. So I'm so grateful that she picked us, my little cousin, my little baby girl cousin. More than anything, I'm excited to just have some days off and be with family and go to the party and have Danny meet my grandma. Oh, I'm just so full of love. I love going to Mochis, and the food, bitch, bomb. Figure I would show you guys a little bit of what I'm gonna be taking, get your opinion on some things, because I feel like when I go to Mochis, it's a little bit of a different experience for me. Because if you're paisa and you're watching this, you might be able to relate, but if you're not paisa and you're watching this, then I'm gonna explain it to you. Basically, in Mexico, tattoos are a little bit, como se dice, not normal. And if you've never seen my arm before, I am hella tattooed. It's always really interesting to go because I feel like people always like stare. Like, I'm pretty tall, I'm 5'10", and over there, though people are really tall in Sinaloa and Mochis, people are taller than normal, I would say. Yeah, I'm definitely taller than average. So I don't know, it's always just interesting to see how people react, and carrying a camera is always different, you know. So we'll see. I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna be taking, but first I'm gonna show you the dress that I'm gonna be wearing at Dana's quince. I don't know if I'm like ruining it by showing it to you guys earlier, but I want to show it to you because it's super cute and I loved it. Let me show you. So this is the dress that I ended up picking, you guys. I ended up getting it at Windsor. It's actually green. I know it looks black from far, but if you look closer, it's like this like green suede-y material, and it has this like iridescent bedazzle like piedritas all over it. So it goes all the way down to my feet, which is good. I actually don't like to wear heels when I'm over there, especially like at parties, because I'm telling you, I'm already 5'10". With heels, I'm like 6'2". Everybody me queda el ombligo. So I picked a dress that was all the way down to my feet, so I didn't have to, you know, be in heels. But it's so beautiful, and I feel like it brings out my skin complexion super nice, and it brings out my eyes. Look. Is that weird? I don't know. Does it bring out my eyes? I don't know. But anyway, it actually ended up looking really nice because it's like tight and it's form-fitting. So I'm super excited to be wearing it. And one of my favorite things about it is that el escote is not all the way down, because I actually had another dress I'll show it to you guys right now. And then the back, this is what the back looks like. So, no está muy escotado, and basically, I don't know how to say escotado in English. How do you say escotado in English? Comment down below if you know. Basically, it doesn't show a lot of titties. Basically, bitch. So, I was actually gonna wear this dress. Look, let me hang it up so I can show you. I was actually gonna wear this dress by Fashion Nova that you guys see right here. It's red and it's simple. It's really long too. But when I try this one on, I'll try to see if I have a picture. This shows all of my boobs. And then the back, if you see the back, it's like a super low cut back. I'm gonna put it over here. So when I show, I actually got that dress for free. So I was like, oh, fuck yeah, I don't have to buy a dress. Like, it's lit. And then I showed my mom a picture and my mom was like, oh no, you're not wearing that. So a mis 28 años, mi mamá me dice que me ponga. So I had to listen to the lady. And I ended up getting this one. I do want to give a quick shout out to one of my lash clients, Michelle, because she works at Windsor. And if you're her manager, then I'm denying this. But Michelle, you know what you did for me, bitch. Thank you so much. I loved it. It looks so beautiful. And I can't wait to show you guys what it's going to look like once it's on. But this is what I have so far. Not a lot. And there's my child. My beautiful baby girl. I wish I could take you to Moshi's. Para que conocieras a tu abuela. But she doesn't know her grandma, you guys. So I did make a list. Let me kind of show you guys. Literally, it says list of things. Okay, that's what it is. So the dress, I need party shoes. So I did tell you guys that I'm gonna be needing like chanclas or something. Underwear, socks, Converse, makeup, straightener, curling iron, wet, oh my, wet brush. That's the brush I used to brush my hair. Skincare, toothbrush, cash, camera, camera charger, phone charger, computer, and charger. SD cards, AirPods, deodorant, selfie light. I am not very far ahead in my packing, so I'm gonna get started with that right now. Let me get it all together and then I'll kind of show you guys what we're gonna be taking and stuff. Let me show you a couple of the pieces I already have, because look, I'm gonna be taking this bodysuit. So this bodysuit, I would wear it with just like jeans and my Converse, you know, super simple, because it covers, it doesn't go all the way down on my boobs. I have this shirt that Fashion Nova sent me too, but the only thing is that it's a long sleeve, which might be good for my tattoos, but bitch, it's so hot over there. Let me get the rest of the stuff ready. We're gonna be there for 9 days, so it's a pretty long time, so I had to take hella clothes. So let me get the stuff ready. And also, look at what I found in my maleta, you guys. You see that red bracelet? I actually got it in Mochi's last year that I went, and I love it so much. So these are the other two bracelets I never take off. So yeah, let me get everything together. I'll see you guys soon. Hi guys.
Hi.
You guys, so it's the second day. I didn't finish the vlog yesterday because I had to go to work. And then it turned nighttime and then it came over. Me ocupé. It's the second day. This is our getting ready for Mochi's vlog. So Amy D's actually going as well. I invited her over to my family's house.
What are you posting this?
I'm just gonna film a lot and then edit. And it might go when we're there, but they don't know when we're going. We're actually gonna be going to like Marshall's, Target, the mall. I'm running like last minute errands today, you guys. Oh, I thought I had like lipstick on my face. We're running last minute errands. So remember how I told you guys with the long dresses? Amy is actually doing the same thing. She's not gonna be wearing heels as well. Because I was telling them, bitch, like here we're tall, you know, like obviously. But in Mochi's, even though people are tall, we're taller than normal
women.
Yeah, than women. Like, I don't know why, because I feel like
because the men over there are fucking tall.
Yeah, and see, that's what it is, huh?
Women, yeah, they're okay. All fucking short.
Yeah, I feel like them. Like, who's the tallest woman in our family aside from us? My mom.
In our family, she's the tallest aunt that we.
She's
have.
The tallest sister.
Well, mi tia, yeah. She's,
oh, she's tall too. And her mom is 5'8", you guys. I'm 5'10", Amy's 5'11", so we're like a little bit taller than everyone, but our grandma's like, well, probably like 4'11" by now. So anyway, she's also wearing flats like moi. Bitch, tell me why I came to get gas right now. Get me out. Can you guys see, bitch? What the fuck? It's already at $37. In this economy. I got the regular. Normally, I get the expensive one, but I was like, no. Se me van calmando, por favor. I have to go to Target. I have to go to the mall to get some lashes. I have to go to Marshall's to get my tia, my cousin, and everybody a gift because, you know, for them, like, hosting us. So we're going to take you guys with us. You guys, this is day 3
day three of my hair, I think. So what I did, you guys, is I cut some layers into it, because what I wasn't liking and that I realized after is that like my hair was so blunt that like if this back piece was behind, my hair would be like out like that, like boom. So now instead, if the long pieces go behind, there's some short pieces that don't look like as crazy blunt, you know? So I think it looks better, it blends well. So I'm liking it a little bit better. I did see that some of you guys commented on my last video and were like, oh, you should have gotten layers. And I was like, yeah, I should have. So I actually did some layers myself. Y'all already know I'm down to do everything myself. So I did it.
Bitch.
Dude, this is nothing compared to mine. We're taking your car everywhere now.
What?
$65.
$65
and
bucks?
I have a four-cylinder, bitch. $65.
I've never paid $50 for gas in this
65
car.
$65 fucking bucks.
This is a four-cylinder too, you guys. Oh my god.
Yo, I look bally that next to you.
You do?
Yeah, because
you're not wearing makeup, that's why. Yeah. Bitch, what the fuck? Look, you guys, and I got the regular. Got me fucked up. Alright, bitches, we're at the mall. We already went to Target and we already went to Marshall's, you guys, but we have not been able to find any sandals because even though it's like starting to be winter, so the sandals that are there are cheaper. I think I want sandals like with a little bit of bedazzle on them so that they're like fancier. Like I know I'm gonna be in chanclas anyway, but like I want them to be fancy chanclas. So we're gonna pull up to Aldo right now and hopefully they have something, because usually they have really good deals. The only bad thing is that estoy patona, so a lot of times I don't have my size. So cross your fingers. Sit. Aquí soy. Aquí soy, please. I'm gonna be like, do you guys have 14? Oh, look, Amy's gonna try them on first.
Don't look at the other sandal. No, y aparte, tip.
So, 10 was a no go.
Okay.
That was short lived.
That was a no.
Bro, what? If only my mom would have made us with a little less love.
Imagine that we're big on size 8, not que ver.
I mean, I know it's gonna be a bitch out there like, I'm 5'12 and I'm a size 4. Like, bitch, I get it, but we're 11 in chanclas. And 5'10 in heels, 11 in chanclas, 10 and a half ish, 10 in shoes. But man, that was kind of sad because those were like perfect and simple. But now we're gonna go to another store, you guys. It's called Spring. I think it's like related to Aldo. I really hope not though. But yeah, you guys, I'm kind of low-key sad, but we're looking for something like that, something simple but that's old, you know. Bitch, we're about to be matching because there's one. Preguntale. All right, that was another fail. They didn't have our size. Everywhere, everyone stops at 10. I demand all shoe stores to please just go up to 11, you guys. So now we're gonna go eat, or
yeah, let's eat.
Okay, so we're gonna eat. On my way back, I'm gonna stop for lashes.
And then I'll go get my blanket.
And Amy's gonna go get her Christmas blanket. What's up, you guys? So we actually just got home right now. I have all of the things with me. I'm gonna be showing you guys what I got right now. But more importantly, let me take you guys to my room. Bitch, so the day I'm filming this is... Alexa, what's today's date?
Today is Thursday, October 17th.
Okay, so... today is Thursday, October 17th, and today, you guys, I don't even really like to talk about these things on my channel, but because of the temp, or like the climate of the situation, I feel like I have to. Today, El Chapo's son, and El Chapo is one of the biggest drug lords in the world, they caught him in Culiacán, Sinaloa. Now, Culiacán is 2 hours away from Los Mochis, which is where we're going. I love being from Sinaloa, and a lot of times people know it most because of their of its drug cartels, but I don't ever like to highlight that part of it because I think there's so many other beautiful things to it. So basically war broke out and the sicarios are going wild to try and get El Chapito. And bitch, it's scary because today's Thursday, so we actually leave like 2 days from now, and Culiacán is shut down, and Culiacán is 2 hours away from Mochis, like I was telling you guys. And I don't know if they're gonna shut down Mochis airport because I feel like it's only gonna get worse from today. I really hope it doesn't. I'm praying for them and I feel so bad for it, but this is a big reason why like I never like to announce before we go to Sinaloa that we're gonna go, because you really never know who's watching. And cancelado, but like it's just scary. So I'm actually gonna be posting all of these videos and all of my Sinaloa videos once we're already back home, but it is really scary. We've seen so many of the videos, and I guess it's just the reality of being from that part of Mexico. Like, I don't have words. Like, my heart is breaking for the families and the innocent bystanders who are getting killed, you know. But I would never talk down on Sinaloa. Like, I love being from there and I'm proud to be from there, but it just sucks that, like, that's the climate that is, like, the world is exposed to, you know. I don't know, like, I feel like Sinaloa hadn't been that bad for like a couple of years now, probably like 10 years, and like to think that it might get that bad again is really scary, because you literally see like bodies on the streets, you guys. No, it's part of what's happening at this moment. Like, my sister and I were just talking, like, fuck, like, are we really about to go? And like, we have the party, like, I don't want to, no le quiero fallar a mi primita, you know, like, I want to make sure that I see my family. So we'll see how it plays out. I'm scared. I'm praying for Sinaloa. Comment down below if you're from Sinaloa, or pray yourself for Sinaloa if you guys know what I'm talking about. Yeah, bitch, that shit's scary as fuck. But I love being Sinaloan, so though I'll rep it to the death of me. Like, I'm not gonna pretend like I don't love it.